Good morning. Welcome back to KVT Nasanabad Vishakhapatnam grammar classes. Today's class is about future perfect continuous tense in future tense. So as you all know that future tense is further divided into four kinds. They are simple future, future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous tense. In this lesson, we'll learn about future perfect continuous tense, its structure and uses. First of all, we'll see what is future perfect continuous tense. Here it is, future perfect continuous tense. We use this tense to show that something will continue until a particular event or time in the future. That is called future perfect continuous tense. It shows that something will continue until a particular event or time in the future. I'll explain you here clearly. Listen, this is future. In future, action will start here. And it will continue until a particular event or time in the future. So, action will start and will continue until a particular event or time in the future. So, we use this future perfect continuous tense to tell about the duration up to a particular point of time or event. That is called future perfect continuous tense. The action will be started and it will continue until a particular event or time in the future. Now, for example, for 5 minutes, since Friday, since Monday, since and for are used in this particular tense, that is future perfect continuous tense. Again, in another way, we can say this future perfect continuous tense is we can use this tense, means future perfect continuous, to say how long for an action that continues up to a particular point of time or event in the future. So it tells about, says that how long the duration, how long for an action that continues up to a particular point of time or event. This is called future perfect continuous tense. See, suppose if we use when, a word when, then we usually need to the future perfect continuous tense. We had to use future perfect continuous tense when. Suppose if we use when, a word in this particular tense. For example, see, when I see you, when I have used this word when I see you, I will have been studying. Means in future, I will have been studying when I see you. So, I will be tired. Here I have used when so that the other sentence should be in future perfect continuous tense. I will have been. This is one key point to remember. Now, we'll see the structure. What is the structure of future perfect continuous tense? The structure is subject plus will or shall plus have plus been plus before plus object. So, subjects I, we, you, they, anything we can take. Will or shall according to the subject and then have plus been. Been is used with before in continuous tense, perfect continuous tense, isn't it? Before means we one plus ing form object as usually. Now, we will see the three kinds of sentences in future perfect continuous tense. In this tense especially, we cannot, means we can use the affirmative sentences and negative sentences only, because interrogative sentences are not in use. Only we can use these two types of sentences. We can use interrogative sentences also, but they are not in use. We'll see the affirmative sentences first according to the structure. See here the example. By next April, we shall have been living here for 5 years. 5 years will be completed by next April. So, that expression should be in future perfect continuous tense. By next April, by the end of the April, next April, we shall have been living here for 5 years. 5 years will have been completed. That is. Now, negative sentences. Negative sentences is formed by putting not after, shall or will. helping verb. Example, they will not have been leaving their city by next year. They will not have been leaving, will not have been leaving their city by next year. That is negative sentences. Interrogative sentences, usually the helping verbs comes at the beginning of the sentence and followed by the subject. But these interrogative sentences are not in use. We need not learn about. Now, uses. What is the uses of future perfect continuous tense? It expresses an action which will be continuing over a period of time that will end in future. Already I have explained you here. This is that will come to an end at a particular point of time or event. That is the uses. See here. It expresses an action will be continuing over a period of time that will end in future. For example, by next June, the government will have been completing 5 years of ruling. 5 years of the ruling will come to an end, will be completed by next June. Till then, the government will have been completing their ruling. So, the process is continuing over a period of time should be in future perfect continuous tense. Here I have given some key points to hints to identify the tense. They are for, since, seems, plus future time. Day, date, month, year, etc. We can use any future time references with this for and since. These are the hints to identify future perfect continuous tense. So, this is about future perfect continuous tense in future tense. The structure is subject plus will or shall plus have plus been plus before plus object. This is about future perfect continuous tense. Thank you.